Anna Welker has a very plush job this morning. Mm-hmm. She gets to be in one of the most gorgeous places in Rochester, inside, yet you get that feeling like you're outside on a July day.
And she, not even here. It takes you, like, I think, different parts of America.
That's
all
right.
Over the
world. I forgot about that.
Yeah, because what you see in there, sometimes you don't see outside here. Hi there. Hey, guys. Yeah, now I'm in what they call kind of the tropical area of the conservatory, Lamberton Conservatory at Highland Park. Mark Quinn, again, the superintendent of horticulture for Monroe County Parks. Mark, this is kind of a tropical escape for a lot of people who are trying to escape the cold weather, right?
Yeah, this is the place to be if it's cold outside. All winter long, you can come in here, and it's just a beautiful tropical environment. It's warm. It's humid. It's just what you want for a place to be inside on a cold day.
It is warm. And another cool thing that I saw, I immediately said these branches are huge. You said these grow bananas.
Yeah, the ones in the back there are the bananas. You can kind of see the flowers.
Oh, my
gosh. The flower on them is the red part, and then the bananas are farther down the stalk. The one right in front of us is a bird of paradise. It's a flowering plant. You can see it's gotten so tall, it's right up against the top of the building.
Oh, my goodness. Now, I got to say, there are some little creatures on the ground right now that Adam's been talking about all morning long. They're the quail.
Yeah, those are our button quail. We've got over two dozen in here, and they just wander around with the visitors. The little kids love them. They're just as cute as can be.
They're so cute. And you said when there are babies born, they're even smaller, and they kind of just, like, scurry around.
Oh, yeah, the babies are about the size of a bumblebee, and they'll hide under their mother's wings.
Oh, my gosh, it's so cute. Now, talk about all of the different, the variety of plants in here. Again, in Rochester, what do you do to grow this type of plant? Because obviously this isn't one that's native to Rochester.
Nope, these are all tropicals, and this is a permanent display. We reopened this building. It was built in 1911, but it was rebuilt in 2007. We reopened, so the trees that you see in here now were planted in 2007. So we actually have to cut things back. We'll have to bring a chainsaw in here and cut things back because those things get too big for the building. There's two general areas. You've got an overstory, which is the trees, and then you've got all these understory plants down on the ground, which incidentally make nice house plants because they actually exist in a lower light environment. The trees tend to shade these understory plants.
And now, do a lot of people come in here and get ideas? Do they ask you if plants like this could grow in their house?
Oh, yeah. We are always happy to talk to people about, you know, what kind of plants they want to grow and what's the best thing. And people come in here for a large variety of reasons. People will come in here and paint. People will sit down and read. People will bring their children in to look at the turtles and the quail, or just walk through and get out of the cool weather.
Yeah, and speaking of the turtles, check these out. I mean, how many are there in here? They're everywhere. I feel like and I love the turtles who are sitting on top of each other on the other side.
Yeah, they stack right up on top of each other. There's only a couple there. Sometimes you see three or four on top of each other. There's probably 20 turtles in this room. We also have tortoises in the other room. So there's a fair amount of wildlife that wanders throughout the building.
Now, was that all from the beginning? Was that here from the beginning, or whose idea was it to bring in the animals?
Well, our horticultural interpreter, Noelle Nagel, is really an animal person. So she's encouraged the animals in here. She brought in the quail, and she's the mother to all these turtles, so they all float over for breakfast when she walks in the morning.
You said you do have to be careful, though, because when you open the windows, sometimes the quail decide to escape.
Yeah, the quail can actually fly, so we do our best to keep them inside because they don't do as well outside here.
Now, you've always been into horticulture, but how special is it to you to be able to have a place like this to offer Rochester?
Really, it doesn't get any better than this. Rochester just has Monroe County, such a beautiful park system and such great resources that people should appreciate. You come here and you've always got something in flower. You can always come to a nice, warm place. And it's just a beautiful place that people love to come to visit.
I love it. And it makes you happy. I don't think you could be sad here. This will brighten up your day, any day. So we'll toss it back to you guys. We're going to the desert next.
Ooh.
Okay, we're going to the desert. So.
Wow. You are traveling today. I love it.
I know.
First class.